Today, I will be giving you a walkthrough of the Panther platform. So basically, the Panther platform is divided into three sections, which is the general section, manage section, and the configure section. In this video, we will be covering only two sections, which is the general and the manage section. The configure section will be covered in a separate video. So let's get started. So in the general section, the first tab that we have here is get started. Clicking on it, you will see various steps which is required in order to have the basic setup of the platform, which is creating the marketplace, adding a slogan, uploading a cover photo, adding some fields and filters, posting a listing, selecting a theme, and invite users. So once you complete a particular step, it will be striked off automatically, and that's how you will be able to set up the basic platform. Moving on to the preview site, it enables you to see the real-time changes that you're doing on the platform. So this is the landing page of the platform. Any changes that you make in the dashboard will be certainly reflected here in the landing page itself or the website itself. Moving on to the next section, which is the manage section. First tab that we have here is of users, wherein all the users who are using the platform or who have signed up to the platform, whether it is an admin, a customer, or an expert, all the users will be listed here. You can even see the user type here, so whether he's a customer or an expert. And if you wish to make any of the customers, you wish to share the admin dashboard with one of the customers, you can even do that by clicking on this particular checkbox, and the customer will have the access to the admin dashboard as well. Please note that being an admin, you can only share the admin access with the customers and not with the experts. Moving on, we have another tab here, which is listings. Listings would basically mean the profiles of the experts that are there on the platform. So as you can see, there are several listings onto this platform. This is Mr. Rajnikant. So along with the category, he has listed himself under, and the author would mean somebody who has posted this listing. So that's how you'll be able to see all the experts, all the profiles of the experts on the platform. If in case you wish to make any of the listing as a feature listing, then you can click on this checkbox and it will be reflected as a feature listing. So now, what is feature listing? Feature listing is something wherein, irrespective of the number of listings on the platform, the feature listings will always appear on the top of the platform. So whether it has been posted today or 10 days early before, so featured listing will always be appearing on the top. Next, we have bookings. Under the booking section, any bookings that you have, that are going on in the platform, for it is a paid booking or a consultation or a session, any sort of bookings will be reflected here in the bookings tab, wherein you can see as to which is the expert who has been booked, expert's email, client's email address, booking date, scheduled appointment, and the price the client has paid in order to get in touch with the expert. So this is all about the booking section. Next, we have conversations. Being an admin, the admin has the access to all the conversations that are going around in the platform. So whether it is a conversation between an admin or a customer, or a customer and an expert, any sort of, so means every conversation will be listed here, and being the admin has access to all these, and he can open any chat and he can always see. Next, we have email users. In the email user section, we give the admin the option to send an email across to all his users or experts or customers. There's a list of options that we have, and clicking on any of these options, you will be able to send emails to them. So let's say I want to send an email to all the experts on my platform. You can even select the language here, and this here you can type in the email body and you can send the email. First, if in case you want to test the email, you can even try sending a test mail to yourself, and that's how you'll be able to send mass emails through your platform. Next, we have the analytics section, which gives you the view of what is going around with the platform as to how much earnings you as an admin have earned till now, how many experts are there. So there are pretty much, as you can see, there are live consultations, how many customers are live, how many experts are live, experts sign up. So this is the real time data. Then if you switch over to the transactions and revenue, you will be able to see all the data and all the reports related to the transactions happening over the platform. And similarly, we have another tab which is of users, and that's how you'll be able to see how many experts are transacting over the platform, how many experts are popular on the platform, if an expert has been booked regularly by any of the customers. So that's how you'll be able to fetch all the data. Next, we have the invitations. So this section basically is for the admins to invite users over to the platform. So let's say you want to send them an invite. So how do you do that? You just click on invite new users. You put in the email addresses here, put in the email body here, and you can send invitations. And that's how you'll be able to invite people over to the platform. That will be all. Thank you.